All right, it's about 9:40 in the morning, mid-June. I had this thing set up since last night to catch the early morning rays, but apparently there was an issue. So it's just starting off at about 9:40 this morning. We're pulling in 62 watts. We're gonna run it the whole day and see how much power we can actually harness out of this thing. All right, it's 10:15. We're about a half hour in. And we're pulling 70 watts in at the panel. Got a small load on it just so that the panel peaks out. It's about a 1 to 2 amp load. It's just charging a cell phone, nothing big. It's 13.4 volts. We're bringing in 5.2 amps. We had a max of 1.8 amp hours charged in, 24 watt hours. Peak of 5.35 amps, minimum voltage of 12.8. We brought in a max of 72 watts. All right, we're just under an hour in. And as you can see, we're pulling in no loads, around 75 amps. It's fluctuating because obviously, small little clouds pass through the sky. Pulling about 5.7 amps, 13.7 volts in charging. Max amps was 5.81. Minimum voltage was 12.84. Maximum watts was 80.1. We charged almost 3 amp hours and almost 40 watt hours of energy. So we'll keep it going. Alright, no load, and just basically charging a battery at 13.8, we're seeing 83 watts. We'll look at all the max values at the bottom left-hand corner, 40 watt-hours, max of 6.05 amps. And 83 watts, let's put under load now. So we got about a 4 amp, maybe 5 amps of load on there. And as you can see, we're maintaining between 75 and 80 watts. And it's 10:39 in the morning, mid-June. So it's doing really well. Okay, the panels have been running several hours now, since about 9:45, I think. I'll double check the time. It's about 2:20 now, so about 5 hours. So we see 91 watts coming in right now at 15.88. There's no load. Amps are 5.72. We charge 13.7 milli amp hours or 186 watt hours. Max amps of 6.86. Voltage minimum was 14.48, and we produced a maximum of 91.5 watts. So let's put it under load and see what happens. It's about a 4 amp load. So we brought the voltage down to about 13.8. We're drawing in about 83 watts at 5.99 amps. 91 watts is still the highest we've seen. So we'll let it sit under a little load for now and keep coming back and checking it. All right, we're about 5 hours and 40 minutes in. It's 3:29 p.m. It's a high 80s out right now. So in order to get an accurate reading, you got to keep a load on it. So you see, we're constantly at 80 watts from the panel down here in the right bottom. The voltage right now, the battery box is charging, is 13.4. Bringing in 5.93 amps. We had a peak amps of 6.86, it looked like. Voltage minimum of 13. Highest watts were 91.5. We charged 17.2 amp hours and made 233.6 watt hours. So I'll show you when you take a load off of it. The charge controller will regulate it somewhat, see how the wattage drops down even though it's full sun out there still. So I'm gonna look into better charge controllers, but the load I'm pulling is about 5 amps, so it's doing very well. All right, we are about 6 hours and 15 minutes in. The sun is still shining bright on the panel. We're bringing in about 75 to 80 watts still, 13.3 volts at 4. Well, it's clouds passing, so it's gonna go down now. About 4 or 5 amps. Max amps we still seeing is 91.5. I'm sorry, max watts. Almost 19 amp hours charged, 255.6 watt hours. Max amperage of 6.86. And a voltage minimum of 12.8. And we are drawing about still a 5 amp load to keep it consistent, because when you turn off the load, the charge controller will regulate it, and we want to see what this panel is fully putting out. Okay, the solar panel has been out for, let me get that in focus for you, 7 hours and 52 minutes. We're putting in about 68 watts, 13.3 volts, 5.14 amps. We've done 23.9 amp hours charged, 321.6 watt hours harnessed, a high of 6.86 amps, and a low voltage of 12.8. We've got a few more hours of sunlight probably. Just let this thing keep going and see what we can get. All right, we're coming up on 9 hours, and try and get that in focus for you guys. 9 hours and 20 minutes. We've done, see if that'll jump back up a little bit. Took the load off real quick. 13.2 volts, 48 watts still coming in at 7:10 p.m. High of 6.86 amps. Low voltage of 12.8, we're bringing in 3.6 amps still, 91.5 watts peak, 27.677 amp hours stored, and 371.1 watt hours. All right, the sun is starting to fade. As you can see there, the wattage is going down now. So yeah, this is about what you can expect out of an average day. There were some flaws in this test. I had about an hour and a half of where the solar panel wasn't facing towards the sun when I was eating lunch, and one of the charge controllers got really hot and started acting all wonky. So we're gonna run another test with all the bugs worked out. And as the sun slowly sets over the trees, we will start to lose power. So 9 hours, 25 minutes, 7:15 p.m. is when everything starts to fall off. All right, we produced a maximum of 6.86 amps, a max peak watts of 91.5, 27.77 amp hours charged, and we produced 372.4 watt hours. We'll go to the manufacturer's website now and check and see what they claim.
If we look here, it says that you can provide 31, well, it provides an average of 31 amp hours or 500 watt hours a day. We're not too far off from there, and we had some hiccups, so it is very close. Put out 91 of the 100 watts that it was rated for. We did do better on the amperage. They said 6.2, and we ended up getting 6.86 while under load as well. So that's pretty good. So it does match really closely to what Harbor Freight is saying it puts out. We'll do some more testing and see if we can hit that 31 amp hours or 500 watt hours per day. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.